Hello and welcome to Hadoop Exam Learning Resources. Today we are going to discuss about AWS Certified SysOp Administrator, that is the newer version of this certification on associate level. The main focus for this session is like AWS services, which are part of this certification you need to focus on. There are many AWS services which you can't prepare for every service to clear this certification. So we basically collected all the services which you need to focus on this for the certification exam particularly. That list will be providing, which you can see in this session, correct? Because what AWS says in general for all AWS certification, if you are going, then they are saying any web service can appear in your certification, which is generally available since last 6 months, which is correct, but still you need to focus on few web services of AWS. Otherwise you would not be able to say like always I'm ready to give an exam, because every now and then AWS announces new web services general availability. Correct. So you can ignore the latest web services which are announced like within last 6 months or something for your certification preparation. So it is very less likely they would be appearing in your certification exam. So let's focus on this, how to like what all services are included. Obviously we're not going to cover like a detail about each individual service here. We would be focusing more of the naming of the web service which you need to focus on. So, and you can also download this PDF which we would be like a Hadoop exam website. So let's start before moving into this. So how you can access this, the same PDF which I am using this video. So you have to go to hadoopexam.com, correct? This is a website. Here go to under Amazon AWS, and in the Amazon AWS you need to select the SysOps one, correct? As we are discussing about this. So once you select this one, there is a recently we introduced the video introduction, correct? We would be adding more and more videos about the certification, so that would be helpful for you to understand in detail, correct? So let me click on this, and once you click on this, though, like this is an in progress page obviously, so because we are yet to record many sessions, so you can just click on introduction, and when you click on introduction, there is a AWS all AWS services for SysOp PDF which you can see, which is like a hosted on Google Drive, so you can basically access it, correct? So this would be like you can see once it is loaded here, so it's open to all. Okay, so this is Hadoop exam website. Now let me go to this PDF which is actually I'm going to use it. So this would be very small session, like just like what all services are part of this certification. There won't be like each individual service now. As of now we are not covering. We would have separate session for that, preparing for that, so that would help you to understand. So you must know this following services basically, and this is also mentioned in the like some alphabetical order or something you can say, correct? So this is the which you need to know, like if you are going for AWS certification. So these are the list basically. And I would say the one of the most important one I'll mark here basically, which you must know. I would say this is all required, you must know this, but still I would say the highest focus on this certification would be on this services, correct? So if I go here, so this is the one which is certificate manager, then cloud formation, cloud trail logs. So these are all under monitoring domain of this, correct? That is what you would be seeing. This is a SysOp exam, so you need to do how to the config, and so Amazon Inspector, a control tower, this all basically. So I won't say like you can exclude any of this web service which listed here if you're going to appear both for this AWS SysOp certification exam. The number of services looks high obviously here, but if you go and once you start understanding this AWS web services, then it is not that difficult, because once you learn, I think you would not forget about this basically, correct? That is what I have like experienced basically. So once you learn that particular service, you don't forget, and you would be able to understand the question in the certification exam, like what exactly they are trying to ask. And if you know the service detail, you may be able to like still roll out the wrong question answers and you would be more closer to the right answer. But still, I would suggest like you need in-depth knowledge of how this like this independently this service works. That's fine, but they are generally asking questions by mixing 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 services, correct? AWS services. So that is where the problems start. Okay. So and they try to make confuse you. So that is one thing which I don't like about AWS certification. Sometimes they try to test your English language, basically grammar, how good are you. So they just put the every, each, all keyword kind of thing and try to test it. This is not the way to test the like basically AWS services, like you have a knowledge or not. Sometimes you get confused just because of English sentences they may create here, correct? So that is what I'm like little bit like if I would say like for other certification exam and this certification exam, you should test on the actual AWS services rather than English, correct? So that is where they just try to confuse you just by putting, even you have the knowledge, but they are trying to confuse you. So this is what I would like say, it's not good, correct? So now these are the services which you must know and like if you are going for the certification. So that's where the practice comes in pictures, like when they ask questions, like you focus on their statement as well very carefully what they are trying to ask. They are trying to make you confuse as much as possible in the questions, okay? So that's where even people have a lot of knowledge about AWS services, still they are getting confused because of the way question is framed, correct? So and their even answers are framed. So these are the all services which you need to focus on for this AWS SysOp certification. So you go and start preparing for the certification. We would start publishing more and more material like videos basically like for this certification exam, correct? In next few modules, we will discuss about each particular domain of this AWS certification they are focusing on, and then we'll start preparing the videos for like specifically the domain side and what you need to learn kind of thing. So that is the page where basically every recorded session would be available here. So you can access it from here. Okay, so these are the services which you need to know. So I don't want to waste too much time here basically, and we will move into the next session soon. So that way we'll focus in domain detail and slowly we'll increase our knowledge level for this. So thanks for watching. I'm stopping now for this AWS service. If you are watching this video on YouTube, then don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.